welcome to the Mars Space Flight Center. We want you to see some of the facilities of our center and some of the work we are performing in the National Space Program. This center is a part of the National Aeronautics and Space Administration. NASA is the federal agency responsible for carrying forward the peaceful exploration of outer space to enhance man's understanding of the universe. Our special task here in Huntsville is to develop the rocket-powered systems necessary to propel scientific experiments from Earth's surface into the vastness of space. We design, assemble, test, and launch the vehicles. You might say we are the long-distance movers.
The National Aeronautics and Space Administration, with headquarters in Washington, D.C., was established by an act of Congress on September 30th, 1958, as an independent agency reporting directly to the President. The NASA mission is the development of the National Civilian Space Program. To accomplish this challenging task, many research centers and spaceflight centers throughout the country comprise this civilian organization. One of these, the George C. Marshall Space Flight Center, located at Huntsville, Alabama, is responsible for providing the rockets for NASA programs. The Marshall Center also supervises research and development in such fields as space guidance systems and advanced propulsion systems. The Marshall Center covers 1,500 acres of Alabama land. Here are organizational divisions that specialize in all aspects of space transportation systems. Dr. Wernher von Braun directs the Marshall Center team of more than 5,500 scientists, engineers, technicians, and support personnel who have already written part of U.S. space history. A self-contained organization operates the center. Dr. von Braun as a deputy director for research and development and a deputy director for administration. There's a public information office and a reliability office. The legal office and the industrial relations office to conduct staff operations. There's a financial management office. And a management services office. A procurement and contracts office. A technical services office, an operations analysis office, and also an NASA resident auditor's office. These staff elements carry out the principal support functions for the entire center. Project offices include a Saturn systems office, the AGENA and CENTAUR Systems Office, the Weapons Systems Office, and the Future Projects Office. Also, there's a Technical Program Coordination Office. Then, there are 9 major operational divisions that carry on the creative scientific and engineering work. The AEROBALLISTICS Division investigates the flight characteristics and trajectories of space vehicles. It operates a wind tunnel that tests new rocket and space vehicle configurations. Elsewhere in AEROBALLISTICS, physicists, mathematicians, and other scientists develop optimum designs for spacecraft and flight plans for space missions. The Structures and Mechanics Division must translate ideas into practical designs. The division conducts research and development work in chemistry, rubber, plastics, metals, and other materials. It investigates the structural stresses and strains to which the giant rockets are subjected. Studies are likewise conducted on rocket propellant systems and mechanical components. The Computation Division operates electronic brains that reduce data from test firings and from spacecraft. New designs are reduced to mathematical equations, fed into the giant computers, and tested thoroughly before any hardware is assembled. Additionally, the computers compile budget data, statistics, and inventory information useful to management. To ensure that the space vehicles perform as designed, the Quality Division conducts an exhaustive inspection program. At every stage in the development, assembly, and testing of the rockets, the division has its experts checking and rechecking for any possible difficulties. Huge space vehicles are fabricated and assembled in the enormous hangars of the Fabrication and Assembly Engineering Division. Here, metal is formed, components and power plants installed. The primary job at this time is the Saturn booster, the 1,500,000-pound thrust 8-engine cluster that will power the largest space vehicles of the United States for the next several years. This division also perfects the tooling essential for industrial production of space rockets. The Guidance and Control Division must develop the guidance and control systems that steer the huge rockets on their flight paths and keep spacecraft on course for flights into Earth orbit or to the near planets. Tracking, measuring, and telemetry instruments and electrical networks for space vehicles are developed here. The Test Division operates the 178-foot static test tower, where the big rockets are secured and fired to check all their operating systems. From a single test firing of the Saturn booster, the division obtains more than 900 channels of data. In this new dynamic test tower, the Saturn will be assembled and subjected to various mechanical, structural, and operational tests. Test Division also operates a power plant test stand, a cold calibration stand, and a component test building to perform experimental and developmental tests on vehicle components and ground equipment, such as turbines, pumps, gas generators, exhaust nozzles, and many smaller components. To the Research Projects Division is assigned responsibility for keeping the entire center abreast of latest scientific and technological developments. This group also supervises research to advance the state of the art. Among the current programs of the division is the investigating of nuclear, ionic, and photonic propulsion schemes that would be employed in deep spacecraft. The Launch Operations Directorate is responsible for NASA launching operations at Cape Canaveral, Florida, and at the Pacific Missile Range in California. At Cape Canaveral, space vehicles undergo final checkouts before they are mounted on launching pads, fueled, and launched into outer space. A 310-foot tower for the mighty Saturn has been constructed. It is the world's tallest structure on wheels. It is 28 stories high. Each of its three platforms are as large as a three-room house. In the tower, the Saturn will be serviced and fueled and made ready for launching. Then, the giant tower will be rolled back on railroad tracks safe from the effects of the blastoff. Other facilities, roads, utilities, fuel storage areas, and a massive concrete steel blockhouse are being made ready for the launching of the Saturn. Most of the human and physical resources of the George C. Marshall Space Flight Center are occupied with Project Saturn. This enormously powerful rocket will become the workhorse of the National Space Program. Looking beyond Saturn, the Marshall Center will develop more powerful space transportation systems. A single engine is now being developed that will generate 1,500,000 pounds of thrust. When a number of these engines are clustered, the United States will have a space potential of immense scope. Meanwhile, the focal point is Saturn. The 8-engine cluster has been successfully static tested in Huntsville, building up a tremendous rocket thrust. The Saturn booster will be carried from Huntsville to Cape Canaveral, Florida, in a specially designed barge, which has been named Palaemon after the ancient Greek sea god, protector of ships. Palaemon is 180 feet long and 38 feet wide. The Saturn booster will be tied down within the center of the barge. Trial runs have been made to test the reliability and worthiness of the Palaemon for this gigantic undertaking, and it has met the heavy demands placed on it. Saturn will begin its long journey in Huntsville, Alabama, but its final destination will be somewhere in outer space. Earth satellites measured in tons, soft landings on the moon, circumnavigation of the moon by manned spacecraft. These are the missions which this giant may undertake in the next few years. This is the George C. Marshall Space Flight Center, a unique assemblage of the most experienced rocket designers and the finest equipment that can be provided. Out of this center will come the vehicles that will continue to carry the United States into outer space.